One of the first things I should point out is this is just kind of all set up for a big experiment to see if it even works. And so I could show other people my troubles with it, or if I had any or whatever. So I hope that helps. These are awesome motors. And if you guys actually figure out a way to put this together and maybe even pull a little power out of it, that would be cool too. I like them as motors. I think trickling power over three phases makes it a better motor to run something else, just in my book or in my theories, my whatever. But some people are turning those into generators and stuff, but I'm not. I mean, maybe. We'll see. We'll think about some wiring to do. But this is awesome. As a motor, it's got a lot of torque. A lot of torque. And it is a little volt battery running it. So I hope it helps you guys. Watch the videos. So make some sense out of it. And if you've got any questions, please just ask. All right. God bless. This definitely looks like a crazy experiment. And there's probably going to be a lot of questions. I think Nikola Tesla and that Italian person kind of came up with the three-phase motor at the same time. But I think Tesla did more with it, in my opinion. But these things are freaking cool. I'll tell you all about it. Get right into it. But honestly, I think they can help a lot of people. Anybody that can put this together, and it's really simple, it's find the parts if you have to, just make it work. I did, and you know what, guys, I think I got something here. But if I can get this in other people's hands and they can do something good with it, then hallelujah. Pray for wisdom on this one. But it is pretty cool. I do say so myself. I did a lot of videos throughout the past few months while I was working on this, and kind of did like a bunch of videos that are all hobbled together, but I hope you guys can make some sense out of all of it. Feel free to ask questions, do whatever it takes, but get one of these to work, because I think they can help people, if done right, you know. I was trying to pull power from there, and yeah, this thing just doesn't work. But just watch the video, so take it all apart. And if you guys need more questions or answers or whatever, feel free to ask. And I hope this really helps, guys. God bless. I'm actually trying my best to put all this in English. I know there's that guy in the 60s that created the BLDC motor and all that stuff, but this is stupid, simple language. Just trying to help people, anybody that can figure this out. I mean, I did, right? And you got yourself an awesome motor that runs off a little battery pack, basically. You could do all kinds of things. I am trying to do the 600 or whatever wind generator head, the low RPM generator head. Get 1,000 or 3,000 watts out of it. I don't know if it'll work, but I'm going to try it anyway. Why not? I have a bunch of friends that have a bunch of ideas that they want to do with these things too, so yeah, guys, just make it happen. These are really cool, and I think they actually can help people. Any questions, feel free to ask, and I'll answer. Alright. Also, if you guys need some parts, feel free to just go on to my link. I source some of these. Probably should get them while you can, especially those controllers. These motors are cool. This is 36 pole too, by the way. It's not the 48 pole, but you could probably make that work too. I don't know. I just like it. Works and makes a lot of sense. If you guys need help with it, ask questions. What I want to do with all this, basically, is put a wind generator head on the back of this. One of those low RPM ones that have to go 500-600 RPM. 1,000 to 3,000 watts. Will it work? I don't know. But am I going to try it? Yeah. Why not? It would be kind of cool to see if I could spin a wind generator head on 18 volts. I'm just saying, that would be pretty neat. Light going. Okay. I had a buddy say he wanted to put this on a parasail. I told him that was a very bad idea, but he swore up and down he had a parachute. I'm thinking log splitters. This motor will work for anything a guy wants to actually put it on. I think is freaking awesome. It's 18 volts spinning this. Like, I got more videos too I did while I was putting this together, because I figured some people would be in the same boat. I'll pick the thing up. Let's see if I can. Oh, I got a clamp on it. But anyways, just that little controller there. I got more videos that explain everything better, but if I could put this on a wind generator head and just have it work. It might be pretty cool. My battery's even low too, I think. Yeah, it's on one bar. See what happens when it dies. Ow, got hot. Ow. Now that thing's got a lot of freaking power. The log splitters, I don't know, anything a guy wants to put this on, go-kart motor, who knows. I'm just saying, it's kind of cool. It's very cool if it charges batteries. What basically is happening here is this battery is on an inverter that goes to the controller. Now the controller is trickling power over three phases, so it's like three motors in one. Nothing's hooked to this thing, but you'll watch the other videos and I'm gonna take it all apart and everything. I did it while I was working on it, because I figured you guys would be in the same boat too. So anyways, I hope this helps, and I hope this video is not crooked the whole time. Still going. I gotta do a time lapse to see how long this will run for too. But yeah, I redid the wires too. Another thing, because in all the other videos, the wires weren't hooked up to the right colors. Like I got black, white, and red. So now I hooked it on the red wire on the red, the white wire on the white, and the black wire on the black. I'll get a good view of that. Anyways, the other videos will actually be better explained. But if I can get this in other people's hands, that would be amazing. I've actually put together a website link for these parts that I've sourced. And different types of drill batteries, different types of inverters. But if a guy can actually make this work for a wind generator head, that would be amazing. But as it is, it's an awesome motor. I'm talking go-karts, bicycles, freaking lawnmowers, motorboats. I don't know what the limit is on this log splitter. That's what I kind of would be cool. And then there's that one buddy that wanted to do a parasail, which I thought was ridiculous, but whatever. Told him I want no part of that. Go slow and then speed it up. That's a lot of pressure. But that's still a few hundred RPM, but let's crank it up a little more. It's going pretty good now. With my hand on it, that's probably 500. And that's all I need to run it, but now this is where it starts to hurt you. If you put a lot of pressure on that thing. Here or two. Okay. Here or two could be battery. Thank you. Well, you just saw what happens when you put too much force on it. By the way, the drill battery's dead too, so. That's amazing. Anyways, I hope all this helps somebody, and somebody smarter than me can actually use it and put something together that helps other people. I put a website link down, and you can just look at it in the description below. It was weird. I'm not good at filming, and I'm not good at any of this stuff, but I figured this stuff out, so if it helps any of you guys, I got more videos that show what it was like going through the process of making it work. I did rewire that motor to Nikola Tesla's standards, I guess. Got the controller here, and yeah, the inverter. Pretty cool. Now I just need a bigger generator of some sort and see what happens. That's what I want to try. Will it work? I don't know. Am I going to try it anyway, though? Yeah, why not? That's so cool. You wire this thing upright. I'm not even using the hall sensors. I didn't really get them to work, but yeah. No hall sensors or nothing. Pretty freaking cool. I got these little guys on here. Yoink. I think I was testing power. I got 2.5 volts from this, but this isn't right, so I'll explain all that as I go through my other videos. Good luck, guys. Hope it helps. Adios.